With this example, we're going to build a program based on a flowchart just to get some more experience with if statements. So here's a copy of our flowchart. It's just a single sample day. So we start here. Is today a weekday? If yes, then do we have class today? If yes, then we go to class. If no, then we go to work. If today's not a weekday, then we take a break. And then after work or break, then it goes to end. So let's build a program that will have the same structure and will print out these same things. So here's our blank program. So let's start out just by printing what's in the box. So we're going to kind of bounce around a little bit, but we'll try to do the big parts first and then fill in the details as we go. So we're going to model top-down design in this program. We've got pound sign include IOStream. We've got our int main. If we need any other library functions, we can always add them later as we go. So first thing to do is just print out something that represents start. And then let's do a line space after the end of that first line. Now it's a little bit silly to run the program at this point, but let's go ahead and run it just so that we kind of get in the habit of anytime we're doing a program that we sort of type in a few lines and then see how it goes. That way, if you're debugging, you kind of know where the error is, and it's a little bit easier to debug. So it prints out, "Hi, this is the daily planning program." Okay, so it looks great. So now we hit that first if block. Now, the most important thing, though, is to prompt the user, "Is today a weekday?" So let's do that first before we even think about the if block. Now, we also kind of need to figure out, hey, how are we going to capture this variable? Why don't we just use a single character? So let's have the user type in a lowercase y for yes, or an n for no. And again, let's just run it and make sure that everything's working. Okay, so today, weekday. Okay, looks good. Okay, so now we've got the text printed out. Now we need the if test. But we don't really have anything to test yet. We need to get this input from the user. So let's try that. Now remember with cout, it's less than, so think of it like a little mouth that's eating what you have to the right of the less than operator. But for cn, the mouth goes the opposite way because the stream is over here in cn and it's pushing it to your variable. So let's give it a variable name. So why don't we just call it response? We could call it choice. That should be fine. And let's try and run it again. It should give us an error, but let's test it. Yep, and sure enough, it gave us an error and it flagged that new line. And if we look down here, it should tell us that we haven't declared response yet. So that's fine. We can fix that. So we'll go up to main. We said we're going to use a character, so it'd be char. It's not a bad idea just to place something into our variables when we first create them. You certainly don't have to, but let's just stick a zero in it just sort of as a default character. It won't really affect the way the program runs one way or the other. And let's try and run it again. Let's see if that fixes that error. Okay, looks good. And so we could type in a Y And we don't have anything after that, so now the program ends. Let's see if we can now build this very first if statement. So we'll do if open parentheses, and then we need some kind of comparison. So what we're testing is response y for yes or n for no. So remember, if you're doing a test for equivalency, which is what we have in this case, we don't want to do a single equals, because a single equals takes what's on the right and just assigns it to that variable that's on the left. That's not what we want. We want a double equal sign so that it's a test. A double equal sign is a test. A single equal sign is an assignment. It's moving what's to the right over and storing it into the variable to the left. So remember that this is a char, so we're going to have to use single quotes. So why don't we build this yes case in the true part of our if. So we'll say if response is equivalent to y. And then what I would recommend is go ahead and put in the open and close brace there for this. But don't put anything in there yet. Just put a comment. That'll help you figure out what the case is. And then looking at this if, we also have an else case. So let's go ahead and build that else case as well. So we'll use the keyword else, and then there's our open close brace with our else. Be careful with when you're doing your open close braces. Most of the IDE editors will automatically put the close brace as soon as you put the open brace in there. So if you wind up with multiple close braces, you may not need to type the close brace. So just be aware of that if you start seeing weird things when you're trying to put the close braces in there. So then this is going to be no, this is not a weekday. Okay, so now let's look back at our flowchart, and always like building the easy stuff first. So this no case where it just tells me to take a break, that looks like that's a little bit easier than building all this additional if stuff over here. So let's go ahead and build it in the no case, and then we can always come back to that other part. So all we really need to do here is just print out that the user should take a break. Okay, now we got a couple lines in there now. So let's try and run it and let's see how it goes. So let's do N for no, this is not a weekday. So it tells us that we should take a break. Okay, it looks good. Let's run it again. We shouldn't get any input if we type in a yes for it is a weekday, because we haven't programmed that part yet. But the good news is that it didn't tell us to take a break, which means that the else is functioning correctly and it's skipping that portion of the code. All right, so we built that. Why don't we go ahead and build the conclusion part of it, because that would be kind of the next easiest piece to build. Okay, so we'll just print out that this is the end of the program. And let's run it again, just make sure everything's working. Okay, looks good. Now we've got that functionality built in. So now let's just continue to add functionality. So think of your program kind of like doing a sketch when you're doing a portrait or something like that, and you're sketching it out. You're going for that overall shape first, and then you're adding detail as you go. So that's kind of what we did here. We built this overall shape. Now we're going back and adding the detail. So we need to prompt the user, do I have class today? That would go in the yes, it's a weekday. And then we really also need to prompt the user to do that same Y for yes or N for no. Let me just copy and paste that down there. All right, let's try it again. So now we're going to say, yes, it is a weekday. And then it prompts us, do we have class today? Okay, so that's looking good. Now we just need to build in a CN to capture their response. And when you're first getting started with C++, it's kind of tempting to build a second variable, right, for the response. But once you're done with this first test here, you really don't need to save that response. There's not really any good reason to save it. So there's not any, I mean, you certainly could create a second variable for the second if, but since we're just going to be single responses each time, we could just go ahead and reuse response as a variable each time. So why don't we just do that? And then what'll happen when the user types in a new value, it'll just clear out the previous yes that was in there, or sorry, the previous Y that was in there. Let's run it again. Okay, it looks like it's working. Now let's build in this next part. So now we need this if. And why don't we build it the same way? So the yes, the y is going to be the true, the no here is going to be the false. So I've got my open close brace for my true, and I'm just going to comment this in. That's just a note for me to remember what part of the code goes where. And then I also have an else case. So I could build that in as well. I kind of have two options though, because after I'm done with the true case, I hit go to work. And after I'm done with the false case, I hit go to work. So I really don't, I could add an else in there and put a go to work, and then also put a go to work here in the true case. But I could just have this if end here, and both roots of the if wind up at go to work. So let's just do that. That'll be a little bit faster and a little bit shorter. Oops. Now let's build in this go to class portion. I'm just going to copy that statement up. And then I'll edit it. Okay, so if our response is yes, then it'll say go to class first. And then it'll end the if true portion. And it'll go to this, you should go to work now. If the if is false, it'll bypass the go to class and it'll go directly to the you should go to work. Okay, so let's run it and make sure it's running. And then let's see if we can get all the different options on this one. So is it a weekday? Let's do the shortest path first. So no. So you should take a break. This is the end. Okay, great. Let's run it again. Now, so we can get the rest of the path. So is today a weekday? So yes. So we're working on this longer side over here. Do I have class today? Yes. So you should go to class first, and then after class, you should go to work. Now, we could put a pause or something in that, but for just a simple program like this, we don't need to do that. And then it finishes up with, this is the end, thanks for using the program. Okay, so that side looks great. And let's try that last case. So is today a weekday? Yes. Do I have class today? No. You should go to work now. This is the end. Thanks for using the program. So we've been able to program in every single part of the if. And again, when you're trying to program, try and kind of view it this way. Try and get the main part of your logic mapped out, and then go back and add details as you need to. So the details might be the variables that you need to go back and declare. The details might be adding additional structure, like after we built this path, we needed to go back and add this path. And don't be afraid to just put in a comment, just like a little sticky note to yourself, that you need to go back and put some stuff in there later, and then feel free to leave a portion undone while you work on some other portion of the code. Probably the least efficient way to code is to try to start at the top on line one and then try to work your way all the way down to the return on line 31. That's probably the hardest and slowest way to code. It's much faster if you kind of think about building a structure and then just leave reminders for yourself and then go back and fill in that structure with detail as you go. Thanks for watching.